And I think we have connected right now with Clint Irwin of the Colorado Rapids. We have connected with him. Clint, welcome to Red Card again, my friend.
Thanks for having me on again.
Pleasure's mine, Clint. I was just talking about two teams that have struggled all year, but you guys came out with a W against Chicago, and that's got to do a lot for your confidence and also for the teams. Talk about it.
Definitely. We knew, there's not too many games left, and we need to start putting some points on the board, and going up against Chicago, being sort of in the same spot as us, we knew it was going to be a tough game, and fortunately, we were able to come together and get the result.
You know, I look at your squad, Clint, and I would say to myself that your upside is much, much greater than Chicago's. You've got some young guys on there, like Dylan Powers, who is going to be around the game a long, long time in MLS, and you've got some guys that are real pro vets, like a Nick LaBraca. You're getting more and more experience and getting better and better as a goalkeeper in the starting role. So I look at the future of the Rapids as a bright one.
I think you're right. I think even so this season, we want the future to be the present right now and try to make the playoffs and see what happens. So I think you're right in that we've got some pieces that bode well for the future, but at the same time, we're focused on the next two games.
Let's talk about Pablo Mastroianni, your head coach, a guy who I had the chance to talk with when he won that championship with Colorado Rapids, and quite an emotional night for him, and we talked quite a bit. And the guy has played a number of games in MLS and now is coaching this young squad, I like to call him, the Colorado Rapids. It's got to be great to have him and Nick LaBraca, two guys that know the league inside out, to pick their brain on the do's and don'ts, Clint.
Definitely. Both those guys have a lot of experience in this league and have basically seen it all. So they're able to sort of transmit that knowledge to us, and we try to do our best to take it on and translate it onto the field. So both those guys are very influential, within the team, definitely Pablo being the head coach. And we just try to take on his experiences and translate that into results.
It's got to be hard, obviously, this season. Still, there's a chance for the playoffs, but it's got to be hard for those Rapids fans who travel and who are real, real solid group of fans that have been through this club through thick and thin. It's got to be hard for them to see some of the ups and downs, but more, let's say, positives going forward, Clint.
Definitely. We're blessed to have great fans out here, people who really know the game, and every time we step out there, we want to win for them. They've supported us through thick and thin the past couple of years, and the least that we can do is just repay them with some good performances and try to extend the season a little bit more so we can play in them a couple more times.
You got to shake your head or pinch yourself sometimes throughout the season, Clint, when you're going up against guys like Kaká, Jovinko, Keane. We can go on and on, all the guys that have come to MLS this year, and now more and more still coming, like Pirlo and Dos Santos. It's almost like playing a video game as a goalkeeper, but you got to be ready, you got to be sharp, and you can't be mesmerized by the world-class players that are on the other side.
Definitely not. We've had some great players come over in the past couple of years, and I think the quality of the league has gone up every year since I've been in the league. And talk about those big-name players and played in Champions League finals and World Cups and big games in Europe. And with them coming over, you constantly have to raise your game and be prepared for what they have to offer. But I think overall it's great for the league and great for the fans who are a big part of that.
And it's got to be great to have Marcelo Osarvis on your squad. Here comes a guy from a club that has a winning tradition, a winning attitude, a no-nonsense type of coach he had in Bruce Arena. It's got to be nice to have this guy in the locker room talking to the youngsters, being part of the veterans, to make them understand this is what it takes to win that championship.
Yeah, I think Marcelo's got a lot of experience, having been with the Galaxy and also some stops around the world, and you can see what he brings to the team every practice, just with his quality and his competitiveness, and I think it's been a real asset to the team this year.
It's got to be also interesting watching the other teams in the league when you get a chance, Clint, the way certain guys have really taken the league by storm. We mentioned Jovinko. We mentioned, obviously, Keane hasn't taken anyone by surprise. He keeps doing it year in and year out. But there's a lot of guys all over the league that now are really taking this league by storm, whether it's a guy that has come from overseas or even from South America. To me, I think this is fantastic for the North American player that's playing in this league.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think, you know, anytime that you can get guys in with maybe different background or different experiences and maybe different styles of play, I think, at least for me, from my perspective, it's more educational than anything, and just being around people from different cultures and who maybe have had a different route to where they've gotten to. I think that kind of expands your perspective on things and really adds at least to your playing career, and then just also on a personal level, getting to know those guys and what they've been through in different parts of the world. And yeah, it's just been one of my favorite parts of being in this league.
Well, on a personal level, going from Charlotte to Ottawa and everywhere in between, it has been a journey of unbelievable ups and downs for you. But right now, you have put the rest of the teams on notice in MLS that you're here to stay in that starting role, and you've done tremendous in trying to keep your team in games that have been real tight. Talk about that journey, that roller coaster ride as a youngster, and now knowing the road that you took, you'll never look back and you'll keep working 24/7 to stay where you're at. Talk to the youngsters. Tell us your journey.
Yeah, it's like you said, it's been a long route to get where I am, and I think it just has made me more appreciative of everything that's gone on beforehand and maybe all those setbacks that I had initially, and just being appreciative of the position that I'm in now and not wanting to lose that position and doing all I can just in terms of preparation and off-season work and training and just really just focusing on improving every day. And I think I've kind of taking that mantra, especially this season, and I think I feel like it's paid off in terms of my performances. So hopefully it can serve as an example to young guys who are coming through who maybe have setbacks and are in the lower leagues, but still feel that they can make it. And hopefully it's just proof that if you stick with it, you can do it.
You know, Clint, I'm a parent of two boys, one a little bit older now, but one's still playing the game and loves it at a high level here in Canada. And I've sent them to numerous camps, clinics, you name it. But one thing, especially up here in Canada that I know, in eastern part of the U.S., there's not a specific goalie clinic or goalie camp. I know of one guy who came up here years ago, and he was an assistant coach with Portugal, and I think he coached in the NCAA with Hartford, Dan Gaspar, one of the best, if I'm not mistaken, worldwide. Don't you think it's time that more and more people start to cater to the goalkeepers and have specific goalkeeper camps instead of throwing them in there with the other position players?
Yeah, I think it's a little bit of a combination of both. You want to be in with position players just so you can learn the game sort of on that level, but I think at least from my perspective, I kind of became a goalkeeper when I went to goalkeeper camp, and just sort of getting that mental toughness that you need for the position and the concentration that you need when you're just doing goalkeeping for a week straight and you're tired and you don't want to give up any more goals. And just all those little things that sort of contribute to your formulation as a goalkeeper. I think you know, the more goalkeeper camps that are out there, I think would be great. I know when I was going up, there was maybe one or two that were in driving distance. So hopefully there's some other coaches out there opening those camps up and getting more young goalkeepers involved in the game.
Absolutely. Clint, I've said this to many, many MLS players that have come on my show. I said it last week to Corey Ash of Orlando. I've said it to Paulo Tornaghi of the Whitecaps, on and on. I'll ask you as well. I still think that Pacific Northwest, Seattle, Vancouver, and Portland are lights out, the best three cities to visit, play in before a game, during a game, and after. But I think the two New York City clubs are really starting to make a lot of buzz and a lot of noise. And I think, again, this is fantastic. Where do you enjoy the most playing as a goalkeeper?
I think, you know, like you said, the Pacific Northwest clubs, probably just proximity for us because, you know, we play there two or three times a year. Playing at Portland, Seattle, Vancouver. Just always great atmosphere, great fans who really know the game, cheer at the right times, involved, you know, when someone's making a tackle or a good pass, they're very appreciative of that. And just overall, just a great fan culture around the game in those cities. You know, it feels like a big event when you're there. So those would probably be sort of my favorite places to play.
Have you noticed ever since the last World Cup in Brazil, where the USA have really opened up a lot of eyes, and obviously the last Women's World Cup with the USA winning it all, that the appetite, the desire of the young boy, the young girl, and the parents wanting to register the kids more and more, especially in your area there, maybe in Denver, Colorado, or maybe in neighboring states, is getting more and more populated by people wanting to play the sport.
Yeah, I think the World Cup really kind of flipped the switch that was, that's been there for the last maybe three World Cups, where it seems like it's really kicked into overdrive just in terms of the interest, and definitely around Denver, and even when we travel other places, just the awareness of the game and the teams and the players who are playing in this country, I feel like is at an all-time high and only going up. So, yeah, it's been great just to get that boost, and, you know, I think it's, soccer's here to stay, ultimately.
Now, you guys are getting ready to take on Houston Dynamo in a couple days' time. Obviously, you guys have looked at game footage with the Dynamo in their last game. You guys know what you need to work on. But I'll ask you this, Clint. I've still yet to see a team in MLS, maybe LA Galaxy, that have an identity, that clubs know what to expect when they're going to play the Rapids, TFC, the Galaxy, on and on. Is there an identity that head coach Pablo Mastroianni wants to institute within your club before the season's out, or has he already done it and maybe I haven't seen it?
Well, I think for us, what we're trying to focus on is just being a hardworking team. You know, we maybe don't have, you know, the big star players that have kind of joined the league in the past couple of years, but what we want to do is make sure that we're not getting outworked on the field, and just being solid around the field and trying to create chances to score goals. And I think, you know, we've come close to accomplishing that. You know, we're definitely not the finished product by any means, but I think we've got some firm foundational pieces in place, and hopefully we can get on the world run here towards the end of the season and make things interesting.
As we close it out, Clint, who has been by your side through thick and thin? Who has made sure that your confidence was always at a high level, and when it was at a low level, they picked you up? Was it a parent, a sibling, a coach? Who stuck by you to see now you living the dream that you have always wanted to live?
Yeah, I think first and foremost, just my parents, just encouraging me and making sure I had what I needed to try to chase this dream. And I think the other person that's been most influential is my former college coach, Darren Powell, who's now director of the academy at Orlando City. Probably talked to him once. It was just about life and soccer, and he did a great job just keep my head up through some tough moments during my career. So definitely my parents and Coach Powell I'm very appreciative of.
Outstanding. Listen, Clint, there's a lot of people up here when we promoted you were coming on that want to make sure that I said hello to you from the Ottawa Valley region. You played up there a little, and a lot of people still remember the games that you played up there, and they're really happy to see the success you have had. So continued success, hopefully a win against the Houston Dynamo, hopefully even more, and a playoff berth for your squad. But again, congratulations on becoming a starting goalkeeper and keeping that position and doing as great as you've done. And we really appreciate you've taken time to join us once again, Clint.
Thanks again for having me on. And, yeah, I'm very, very appreciative of all the people in Ottawa who still support me to this day. And, I'm always kind of checking in to see how the soccer interest is going up there. And it was a great place to live for 6 or 7 months. And, just like to say hey to all those people back up north.
Absolutely, and you just did. Again, good luck against the Houston Dynamo, and Ottawa's got a real strong team in the NASL, the Ottawa Fury, who are sitting in first place. Big couple games for them coming up. Clint, thanks again, and enjoy the rest of your night, my friend.
All right, thank you again.
Clint Irwin, class act goalkeeper with the Colorado Rapids, a guy that many people now in MLS know who he is. Not when he entered into the league, a lot of people didn't know. You got to watch the save he made this weekend. An unbelievable acrobatic save, and the guy has been lights out good every time he's been called upon. Yeah, Colorado's had a tough season, but they're a young squad, and Colorado will bounce back, and they might do it still before this season is out. I never thought that they would have won that MLS championship that year in Toronto, but they did, and everyone never expected in there. So watch out. Anything's possible.